हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू दी मास्टर कैंप फॉर सॉलिड वर्क्स ट्यूटोरियल सीरीज। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी ए पॉकेट ऑपरेशन। सो एज यू कैन सी, दिस इज द पार्ट दैट वी आर गोइंग टू क्रिएट। ओके, दिस इज द पार्ट दैट वी आर गोइंग टू क्रिएट एंड देन वी विल सी हाउ द पॉकेट ऑपरेशन कैन बी कैरिड आउट ऑन दिस। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। I will first select the I have created a new part in SolidWorks and I will start my sketching from the top plane. Okay, I will first create the corner rectangle of 150 by 100. This length is 150 mm and width is 100 mm. Okay, now here the fillet are required, so there are four fillets of 12.5 radius at the four corners. I'll say okay. I will extrude this. In the downward direction by 25 mm. I'll say okay. Now, as you can see on top, I require to create a pocket, and before that I'll place this hole and I'll give some dimensions. So the hole dimension is going to be 12.5 radius. Okay, so diameter will be multiplied by 2. Okay, and it is at distance 12.5 from top end as well as the side end. Yes. One more thing is required. Okay, I also require the offset entity. So what I'll do is, yeah, so this is 12.5 offset, and I will select one more thing. Yeah, this is also 12.5 offset. So now what I will do is, I will just try to trim the unwanted entities out of this. So yeah, these I have trimmed, and now I just have to give the corner radius values. So as you can see in this picture, yeah, this radius is 5 mm and it is at 8 positions. Okay, so that value I will give from fillet. This This is radius 5. So that is how I will be also trimming this unwanted part right now. Now I have this geometry with me. What I'll do is, okay, there are multiple ways to create this. Okay, so I'll go with the linear sketch. Instead of that, there is also a possibility to mirror this geometry. So for mirror, we will require two center lines. Yeah, that way. And then we'll mirror the entities. These are the entities, and I'll mirror this about the horizontal line. So that is my first mirror, and then I will select again these two entities. Mirror them about this line. Okay, so now everything is complete. Now I just have to join them. Like this. I'll provide a few dimensions over here. This is 12.5, that is known to us, and the offset distance here is also 12.5, that is also known to us. Okay, so this is the top of the pocket we have created. Okay, I will want to extrude cut this by distance equal to 15. So this is the cut that is expected to be made. And the last one is the drilling holes, which are through holes required of 510 mm. Okay, so for that I will again go to sketch, and even we don't require to go to sketch, we can directly use the hole wizard operation. Okay, so I'll select a normal drill hole. Okay, so it is dovel hole. The size I am going to select is 510 mm, and it is going to be a through hole. I'll go to positions, I'll select this, and I'll place it here, and I'll just dimension this. The centers are known to us, is 12.5 from either ends. and then we'll do a linear pattern of this. So here I want only 2 and they are at distance 125 apart. Okay, as you can see in this image, 125 apart, and in the top direction it is 75 apart. So I'll select direction 2. Again, two numbers, the distance is 75. I will change the direction. Okay, so now everything is set, 75 125. So this is the required geometry. Okay, this is the required geometry. I'll just save this to an appropriate location. You can give any appropriate name, and then I will move into the MasterCam toolpath manager. Okay, here I'll first have to set up the properties. So I'll go into the tool settings. I'll give some preferable program number, let's say 1010, and we will have user defined values. So spindle speed is going to be say 3000 rpm. okay, feed rate is going to be 150 millimeters per minute. Okay, and I will be changing the material to these are the material properties. I'll select the mill library and change the material to 304 steel 304. It is stainless steel 304. In the stock setup, okay, we are going to select the stock. So I'll go to bounding box and I'll select the top and bottom surfaces of my part to indicate the overall dimensions of the part. Okay, and yeah, since it has the fillet, okay, it has got that fillet. So what we will do is, okay, in terms of X and Y, we will have slightly more value of the stock. Okay, slightly more value of the stock. Okay, we'll keep this as origin, and so let it be there. Okay, we'll not increase the stock size. Okay, we'll keep the stock size same. We'll just make sure that we are going to remove the sides, okay, with the contour milling. Okay, we are going to remove the sides with the contour milling. Okay, let us just see whether the stock gets created at the desired location. Yes. Now the first operation that we will apply is the contour milling for the sides. So I'll go into the contour milling. I'll select this as the, I'll right click. Okay, once I hover my cursor onto any edge, it highlights. I'll right click on it and say select loop, and I want to select the bottom edge, okay, all the edges of the bottom in loop manner, so it creates the single loop for it. Okay, I'll say okay. So the aim over here is, okay, I will come from top and try to have my workpiece in a proper shape. So for this operation, I'm going to select a flat end mill. Okay, I'll just filter this and say end mill flat, and I'll select an end mill with equal to, let's say, 15 diameter. Let us see the tool is available. Tool is not available. Let us see how many tools are available. Yeah, so all the flat end mills are 16 and 14 mm is available. So I'll select the 14 mm flat end mill. Let the tool holder be standard. Okay, this is the cutting edge of the tool. So accordingly, we'll have to give the depth of cuts. We move into the cutting parameters. So the compensation direction. Okay, this is the cutter diameter compensation. Okay, so we'll keep for the time being as let's say right. Okay, and tip compensation is tip. Okay, and we'll not have any stock to be left on the walls or floors. Okay, we'll give the depth of cut. Obviously, the depth of cut maximum rough step is going to be 5. Okay, there won't be any finish steps required. Okay, I'll keep the tool down, and then in lead out, I will use an entry point and similarly use an exit point, and adjust start of the contour, let's say 75%, as well as adjust end of the contour. Now complete breakthrough is also not required. The breakthrough can be taken here in terms of, let's say, since on the sides we have to finish the final layer, the bottom layer of the workpiece, so we'll give some breakthrough amount over here. So that breakthrough amount will be 1.25 mm. okay, multi-passes may not be required. Okay, we'll see how it tries to, or at most what we can do is we can give one multi-pass with, let's say, spacing 2, and two finishing passes with spacing 0.5. okay, and in doing so, we will keep the tool down. So as the tool approaches closer and closer to the workpiece, the workpiece is going to have good surface finish. Then we'll go to the linking parameters. Make sure everything is absolute. Okay, the depth is, we will again reselect it, that is -25. The top of stock is going to be 0. Okay, feed plane let it be 10, and retract let it be 25. Okay, home and reference position of tool let it be the default from machine, that is 250, minus 250 and 250. Then planes are already selected accordingly. So master cam top. Coolant I will switch on the flood type coolant. Okay, I'll apply all the settings and say OK. And now as you can see, this is the tool path that I get. Okay, this is the tool path that I get. So my compensation direction was precise. I'll just verify the selected operations. Yeah, so as you can see, since we did not give any extra this thing, stock size, and we only concentrated on removing the corners. Okay, so the tool is not actually is going to touch the workpiece wherever it is flat. Wherever we require the curvature, that is fillet radius at the corner, there only the tool is going to touch, and precisely it is going to machine the corners. So I think that is fine. Okay, it takes around 1 hour 21 minutes because it is moving around the tool, okay, moving around the workpiece, and the workpiece is of 150 by 100 dimension, and it has got that many depth of cuts. Okay, so that is what increasing the size, increasing the time, but apart from that, it is acceptable. So now the next thing that we are up to is the drilling. So very quickly we'll do the drilling settings. So I'll go to drill, and I'll sequentially select the drilling locations. Okay, now it is all the holes are of 5 10 millimeters, that is diameter 10 millimeters. So we'll have to select a 10 millimeter drill. Remember, we are directly going to select the 10 millimeter drill, okay, and not going to select the center drill first and then the actual drill. Okay, so we are directly going to select the 10 millimeter drill over here. So as you can see, the solid carbide drill 10 mm, okay, that we are going to select. This is the holder. Yeah, so this is the drilling tool that we are going to select. Now there is no stock above the hole, so this is not useful. And the drilling depth is 25 mm, so if you want, you can use the peg drill operation, okay, and continuously go on increasing the depth of the drill at successive iterations, okay. But since 25 mm is not much, so we'll not use it right now. Then we'll directly go to the linking parameters. Okay, make sure everything is in absolute mode. The depth, again I will redefine. It is always better to redefine it. Okay, so top of stock, again I will redefine to 0. Okay, let retract be 100. Okay, I'll not, and clearance will be required, and clearance I will slightly reduce, let's say 50. Okay, so that it can go and change the tool and again come back. Okay, tip compensation is obviously necessary. Okay, breakthrough amount, I will slightly increase it to, let's say, 0.75, so that finished hole is obtained. Home position of the tool will remain the default value. I'll go to coolant and switch on the flood type coolant again, and I'll say apply and OK. Now you can see the drilling cycle is already, tool path is already drawn on the screen, as you can see over here. Okay, we'll select both the operations and say verify. Before that, we'll just save the part for the safety, and then verify selected operations. Now both operations will be simulated over here. Yeah, this is the first contour milling from the sides, and then the drilling, and then the drilling. If this was very fast, just go back. So this is about the drilling also. As you can see, through hole is drilled. There are no burrs at the bottom face of the part. So that breakthrough that we mentioned for drilling was very helpful. Now we will actually come to the pocket operation. So again, right click, mill tool paths, and pocket. You know, pocket milling and normal contour milling, they are almost one and the same. The pocket means we have to create a cavity having certain depth. Okay, the cavity is not going to be a through cavity, but having certain depth, and that cavity creation needs to be done inside the material. Okay, so there is no outway, or there is no entry point from the outside into the part, but the cavity generation needs to happen inside the part. So that is only the change. Again, the selection will be based on, once you hover your cursor over the bottom edge, the edge highlights, okay, and then accordingly you are going to select the, you are going to right click and say select loop, and make sure the proper loop is getting selected. So this is the correct loop. I can change the direction, it selects the wrong face, and again change the direction to make the proper selection, and then I'll say okay. So pocket, as you can see over here, this is a pocket operation. The important selection over here is what tool we are going to select. So the tool that we will be selecting is bull end mill, and we will also have, let's say, spherical end mill. And let us see how many of the tools are available in the library. So there are many tools available. I guess we deselected it. So let's say first none all. Yeah, now I have spherical end mill and bull mill, and I'll say okay. Yeah, these many tools are available in the library. So I will go with nose end mill with corner radius as 6. Okay, so diameter is 12 and corner radius is 6. So I will select this tool. Go to the holder. So as you can see, this is a spherical mill. Okay, spherical mill. So it has a considerable spherical shape on the corner. There is no corner on this particular tool. Okay, there are other tools as well. So if I go back, okay, instead of this ball end mill, if I select, let's say, this particular tool, that is end mill with 12 mm as the radius and corner radius as 2 mm. Okay, let us just showcase how that tool looks like. Yeah, so this is, so among these two, I guess the more preferable tool is this bull mill, okay, which has considerable flat surface as well and a smaller corner radius, because with higher corner radius we might have to run one more iteration to finish the pocket. Okay, to finish the pocket. So ultimately we will be doing that, but then in that finishing process we'll have to do more work, because the corner radius of all these edges will be more in terms of the spherical end mill. So we'll go with the bull end mill with corner radius 2 mm and the diameter of the tool as 12 mm. Come into the cutting parameters. So machine direction is going to be the climb, that is the clockwise direction of rotation for the tool, and the direction that it is going to follow is also in the clockwise direction. Okay, I'll say tip compensation. Okay, tip compensation. So tip compensation means we are going to utilize the tool length compensation over here, and the direction of the machining, there we are utilizing the cutter diameter compensation. The standard pocket type we are going to use, and we'll leave some stock on the walls and floors so that we can finish it in the finish cycle with the help of, say, flat end mill. Okay, with the help of flat end mill. So we'll say leave 1 mm each the stock. Okay, you can have more stock also. Okay, going into the roughing. Okay, I'll say constant overlap spiral. That is going to be the rough cutting method, and the entry motion is going to be helix. So the tool is going to make some way for itself, and then it is going to go ahead and start the pocketing operation. Okay, center on entry point, and remaining things we can keep as it is. What are the things? Minimum radius 50% and maximum radius 100%. Z clearance is 1, XY clearance is 1, and plunge angle is 3 degrees. So if you see over here, okay, that is how it goes down. Okay, that is how it goes down. So these are default values for the tools. Okay, and these kind of pockets and slots are only possible on the higher end CNC machines. Okay, it is not possible on 2.5 axis CNC machine. Okay, so you require the required amount of facilities in the CNC machine so that you can run these stuff. Okay. I can say follow boundary, or we can get rid of the follow boundary thing. Okay, helix is what we are going to use. Ramp is that it goes down at a single plane. Okay, it's a planar entry. Helix is a three-dimensional entry. Okay, three-dimensional entry. So that is more convenient, I would say. At a given moment, it reduces more material. Okay, it removes more material. Then same with the finishing. Okay, finishing cycle, I will say, it doesn't actually matter because we are going to have a separate finishing process with a different tool. So you can have default values over here, okay, because ultimately we'll be finishing using different tool. Then you can say lead in, lead out. Okay, use entry point and use exit point. A depth of cut is very important. So I'm going to give depth of cut, maximum rough step. Again, I will specify as, let's say, I have to achieve 15 as the total depth. So I can say 4. I will specify maximum rough steps. And then I will specify 2 with finish step size as 2. Okay, finish cut numbers are 2 and finish step size as 2. So or you can say, I will say finish cuts 3 and finish size, so finish step will be 1. Yeah, that is fine. Then keep the tool down. So while it is going to go through between the rough step and finish step, the tool will be kept downward. Okay. Breakthrough is not required because it is not a through cut. Okay, linking parameters is very essential. Make sure everything is absolute. Okay, depth here you have to specify because otherwise it will continue the entire depth. So depth is minus 15. Top of stock, it's always benefited to select the top of stock again. Feed plane, let it be 10. Retract distance be 25. Okay, home reference position. Okay, these values doesn't change unless and until you change them from your end. And the last thing is the coolant. So I'll switch on the flood type coolant again. I'll apply the properties and say okay. As you can see, this is the way pocketing is going to be carried out. So what I'll do, I'll select, and first of all I'll save. Okay, that's always better to save. Then I'll select all the operations. So one by one, each will be carried out. I'll say verify selected operations. Okay, so the verification will be showing us from the step number one, the operation number one. Yeah, so I'll say okay. So this is the pocketing that it carries out. Yeah, this is the final step. Yeah, so three final steps, that is finishing steps. So as you can see, this has the corner radius over here. Okay, this has the corner radius over here, which can be removed with a finishing cycle. Okay, which can be removed with using a finishing cycle by following the similar things. Okay, by following the similar things. So the total time taken over here is 2 hours 52 minutes. Considerable amount of time is required. Okay, I'll close this. Okay, and let us have a very quick, I would say, pocket again. Okay, again you are going to select on the similar lines, select loop, say okay. And here we will select, there should be no stock to be left on the I will select the flat end mill for the finishing operation. Okay, there should be no stock on the floors as well as walls. So we'll leave everything the way we have specified. Okay, we will leave everything the way we have specified. Okay, we will not change anything over here. Okay, we will not change anything over here. We leave everything the way we defined the first operation. So the first operation was a roughing operation. and this is going to be a finishing operation. So all these steps will be as it is. Only thing is we have changed the tool. The only thing is we have changed the tool. Again, just confirm whether the parameters are same or not, and they are same. Coolant is also going to be remaining same. So all the parameters are same. We have only changed the tool to flat end mill. I'll say apply and OK. Now one more cycle is applied. Now if I say select all, okay, and try to verify, now it will give us the total picture. Let me just orient this in a proper way. Yeah, and we'll start. This is the first operation. Then the drill, then the first rough cut for pocketing using the bull end mill with corner radius as 2 millimeters. And then the flat end mill for finishing the hole pocket. So now as you can see, it has properly finished the pocket, and now this is a complete operation. So it now took around 4 hours 17 minutes. Okay, again as I mentioned, okay, if you are okay with that pocket, if you are okay with that nose radius on the sides, okay, then there will no requirement of the finishing operation with the flat end mill. So it depends what type of finishing is essential. Okay, so I hope this is understood. Okay, the activity was just to showcase how to set up the pocket milling operation on the MasterCAM for SolidWorks software. So I hope you have understood this. Okay, hope to see you next time with more such interesting content on computer aided manufacturing and the MasterCAM for SolidWorks tutorials.